Hello and welcome back to Mordheim City of the Damned and the adventures of our reckless rangers with me, Bardon. Last time we decided we were going to do this Hunters and Prey simply because it's a normal mission and it offers average amounts of wordstone compared to this one here, which is a hard mission, which only offers average as well. I don't like the fact that we're split up, because we've seen in the past when we get isolated, we're in real trouble. But I'm hoping that I can get the two groups together as quickly as possible and then move as one set. So let's get in and get deployed and see what happens.
An enemy warband is fragmented into small patrols, possibly to try and slip past your own warband and escape with some wordstone. Aware of these patrols, you quickly dispatch your own forces in small groups to intercept them and prevent any enemies from leaving the area without a fight.
Okay, so let's start with Paris. Now, since the last session, so today is a new recording session for me. So since then, episode 1 and 2 have gone live, and I've had some really great comments from Game Night and from David is Trying, and they've been really helpful in terms of pointing out some tactics I can use and some changes I should make. So one of the changes is that Game Night suggested that our guys in their offhand should have, or basically their alternate set of weapons, should have a mace and a shield. So I went to the shop and I bought a mace and I bought a shield. There was only one available of each. And Paris, being the great leader that he is, decided that the person who needed most protection was him. So kind of sticking to his cowardly ways, at least for now. Now let's see, where can we deploy? So the enemy are going to have one group there by their wagon, so we probably don't want to use that one there. So we put four people there and three people here. So those aren't good choices. So I think what we're actually going to do is put three people here and three people here, and then head towards their wagon and deal with the group that's there. I think that's going to be our best bet, because if we put a group here at our wagon, they're so far from everyone else, then then it is going to be basically one small group against another small group, and my guys don't fare too well when that happens. So if we're going to do that, we're probably going to use this route here to get the guys together. So that means that these wordstone points here are going to be of interest to us. So let's mark them up. And then let's try and get a balanced group going in each set. So Paris is going to be here, because I believe this side is the... Hang on, let me check. Yeah, this side is the one that's furthest away, in terms of we're gonna meet probably around here and move down, so it makes sense for him to be in this group. Brascus then can go with Paris. Morjax can go. I'm gonna put Morjax in the other group, and then Game Night can go here. David over here, and then finally Grace over here. Okay, so we can set off now. So we've got some wordstone there behind us. So Paris is gonna go have a quick look at that. Nice, it's a lot of fragments. If there had been one shard here, instead of four fragments, there'd actually be more away than Wurtstone. But they're here, so we may as well take them.
Objectives updated.
And in terms of their weight or their value, it doesn't matter when it comes to the optional objective. It's just pieces of wordstone, not weight of wordstone that we have to get. So at least that is to our advantage here. You know you want to pick the last one up. There we go.
Objectives updated.
And then we can take our marker off the map. And then I want to put them somewhere where the guys can reach. So maybe say about here, because someone else is going to have to take that wordstone there. So let's overwatch here. But we've actually seen their leader already. So where have we seen her? And we're against sisters as well. Sisters and ranged is not good. So she's down there. So she's going to be coming up this way to us. So she's bringing a group. So I think our plans might change. Because if we head to their cart and they have another group there, then we're basically just setting up that. We're facing off one warband against the other. And we don't want to do that because the sisters are beasts when it comes to melee. So what we want to do is find somewhere where we can fight her group and take them out. And then go sort out the other group, or sort out the other group when they eventually arrive to where we've set up. And also talking about... where we're going to set up. Another tip that I got from game night is that basically I should be using the same tactics that I use when I play melee heavy warbands, which is to use tight spaces to restrict the number of enemies who can actually come and attack us, and from there then use our guys at the back to pepper the enemies and use basically superior numbers to take them out. So looking at where we are here, I suppose the ramp is a possible choke point we could use, but or maybe down there where the buildings are. So let's move on a bit more with him, get to here and overwatch. Now, her movement isn't going to allow us too many more turns to find a place to set up. But let's set him up here so he can overwatch when she comes around the corner. Hard against sisters really is not the mission that I wanted to continue our role of good fortune, but maybe we're going to be okay. It's just a maybe at this stage though. Brascus can cut the corner here. So we got one piece of wordstone here, check the gather.
Objectives updated.
Okay, and then Morjax is over there. So let's go, let's bring him back so we can actually see a bit more and overwatch from here. Now there are lots of bottlenecks over where those guys are, but part of the problem with it is that there are many entrances, so the sisters can get around any blockade we set up. So we do need to, if we can, possibly find somewhere else. So. Also, let's check to see if we have... Yeah, we've seen there's another sister there. So she's part of her group, but she's moved before her. So that's as far as they're going to get. So there may be... one or two, depending on how slow our guys are, they're one or two rounds away from getting to us. So we need to come down here, have a look at how this street looks, whether there's any kind of blockade, and possibly use here as either here or here as the areas where we're going to set up. So let's get to that. So Morjax can come this way and he can get his loot on here. Okay, there we go. So we got a halberd and a gun. Okay, and early on, white items are fine. They're something we can sell. So there's our group down there. Okay, so here, if the sisters wanted to attack us, they'd have to go up and over. So here isn't a bad place to set up. I'm worried that the sisters are going to catch the guys though before they get here. So I want to. So have we seen anyone down there? No, we haven't. Okay. So let's set Morjax on an overwatch here. So I'm kind of hedging my bets here and giving us the opportunity to go to them if we need to. But I'm really hoping that Paris' group can come to us instead. Okay, then we have Game Knight, who's also going to the corner. I want him to grab the wordstone. Oh, give it to Savagery, that's nice. But it does end his turn, unfortunately. Okay, so let's overwatch here. I'm hoping that tiny bit of movement there isn't enough for a sister to come and engage him. Okay, now David can move out. And he can overwatch here as well. So we've got an. I was going to say we had an alternative there in the street here, but the fence is broken too soon. So the sisters could easily run around and engage. And I think our warband is too small, really, to be hoping to be holding an area that size at the front. So. What I want to do is, the sisters are going to come this way, and they're probably going to come more or less a straight line. So I want to put down a powder trap here. Let me think. So let's put the powder trap here. Okay, let's hold off on that for now. And we start putting down traps once the other guys are here. So let's overwatch. So we know we've got one group of them in pursuit of us. So Paris should be able to make the transition over here to this group, which he does. But that's going to leave the other guys, so he needs to come and overwatch about here, I'd say, just to protect their flank or protect their rear, as it were. so we got to shoot her. Hopefully she doesn't get to come and hit us. She's hit a trap, it should reduce her movement. And then she got Overwatch again, which is great. And then that's as far as she can go. So combined with the trap and a couple of Overwatches, that was enough to stall her. Next round now, she is going to be able to get the game knight before he can get into the breach. I'm not going to reload. I'm going to try and get this wordstone without using a blue pill. And then let's exit. So I'm going to use Morjax's wiggle technique. Try and save myself a blue pill here. So we're still looking okay. We need to go back now. Okay, so that's as far as I can go without interacting updated. Wordstone. Okay, so we got that. And now we need to just hightail it out of here. And end turn there. Okay, now Morjax is going to move up a bit and Overwatch from here. Basically, what we're trying to do is to use our Overwatches to burn their pills so they can't get to game night. But I really want to get the guys back into that breach if I can. Let's move Brascus on here. Just about in here and end his turn. David can move up a little. And he can overwatch from here. Also, here's their other group coming as well from the side. Okay, but our Overwatches are doing some good damage to them. And they can't get to us, which is good. But I know Game Knight doesn't want to look at where the Mother Superior is, but we need to, so let's have a look down the road. And then I think that lady is with that group over there. She hasn't got here anyway. Okay, and then Grace. Okay, so Grace can come forward. So it's likely the one in there is going to come through the gap in the wall. So let's put down trap here. Okay, and then move out of the way. We're not going to be able to reload, unfortunately. And then I want to put her. This would block the entrance if I put her here. So let's put her in a dodge stance here at the entrance. And the idea is just to pile in the henchmen in behind the two heroes.
A new round has started.
So Paris doesn't have a shot. He could move up. Doesn't need to move to shoot that one over there. I don't get why he can't see her over there. Okay, Ah, so it's just the pistols have really poor distance, I guess. Okay, so four pills. So we need to save pills to take a stance. Okay, so we need to save two for those. I think he can maybe get there in two, but I don't want to risk it, so and I need him to shoot and then delay, let the archers get in behind them and then take a stance, I think. So let's shoot her. Okay, that's good. And then let's move back to about here. Going to delay for one. I'm not sure I can get all of the archers in because they've got people close who are going to be able to engage us. At least he went for Paris. Brascus will. Let's move him a bit. So let's get Brascus to reload.
And has started.
Okay, so I'm not sure exactly what happened there, but Mordheim froze on me, so I have to restart the game. Hopefully it doesn't affect anything too much here. So Brascus can shoot and move and then get in behind there. Okay, so let's do that now. So we want to shoot her. Miss, and then let's get him back in right here. Okay, and end his turn. And now Paris, he can disengage. Thankfully, I was worried about. And the fact that we've got someone right behind him that he wouldn't be able to, but he can. So let's disengage. Move him to about here. Yeah. Move to here. And then end his turn. Morjax is going to move back behind the barricade as well. Here, so reload. And, take an overwatch. Game Knight, who's our furthest forward guy, needs to move. Let's bring him here. Reload for one. Got a shot, which is great. Let's take it. Okay, unlucky miss there. And end his turn. Okay, so she got overwatched in the face. And the trap worked, which is great. And then she's come for pass, which I expected. Okay, David then, let's move him. Oh, we can't get around now. We've been blocked by our own trap. So let's move him up and over. Really wanted to get him down, but I can't do that, so I'm gonna reclaim this build, reload. Okay, and then take the shot that he has. And then end turn there. So really wanted all of our guys in behind Paris and Grace down below David here for this to work. So it hasn't, so we're gonna have to improvise and see what we can do from here. Okay, so Grace isn't engaged, so because of that, with our new rule, we can't switch her to a different, we can't switch her to melee basically. So we only got her as a target at the moment. But I really want to shoot this one that's blocking the way. So let's move a bit so we can actually shoot the lady that's right beside us. There we go. Okay, we got a shot now. Let's shoot her. We've slim chance of taking her out. So hopefully only 51% chance to hit. That's not very good. So there's only one more person to act in the round, then we have people. So really what we need to do is to take the shot with the best chance right now. So let's do that. So there we go. So we hit her. So that's not damage wasted. Then we're going to head up this way and end our turn here. So there's another one coming from that direction, which is interesting.
A new round has started.
Okay, so Paris finally gets to switch weapons. And attack her. Okay. At least that worked. So he can swing in again, so I want to do that. That's nice. And now I don't want him in the front line anymore because he's almost out of it. So let's move him back here. Let's try and protect him with the guys, so let's dodge stance here. And now someone else is going to have to go and fill the gap. So she looks to be heading for an alternate way around, but she's coming in to fight. And Game Knight is the one got selected, so he can switch weapons. Swing in. Okay, that's good. Parry fail, that's nice for us. And then take dodge stance. Okay, Morjax can reload for one. Shoot anyone, so he's gonna have to move. Let's move back. Okay, now he's got 87% chance to hit her. But I really want to focus fire on the people who are already engaged. So why don't we back up a little bit? Yeah, she's engaged in combat, so it's gonna be less of a chance to hit her. Can aim the shot. So let's aim. And we're hoping that the dice gods are with us here. Okay, there we go, 17. Might as well receive. And then end their turn. Brascus will reload for one. Here. So he has a shot on her. That's it. I don't really want to move him back anymore because we're conceding ground to them. Which I don't like. Let's just move back a tiny bit though. So I want to kind of make it harder for them to get more people in here. No, I don't want to scavenge them. Release the box in his way of seeing her. Must be. Okay, now we can shoot her. Okay, let's take the shot. Now we're spreading our damage around a bit, which I don't like. But at the moment, we've got not much choice. And then let's end his turn. Now David can make his way down this way. Jump down. Okay. Come over here and join these buddies. Reload. So I'm gonna help watch this. Yeah. Sorry for a second. Yes, 70%. That's the other one. And a miss. It's not very good. And then let's end his turn. I think this enclosed base probably next time not the best place for us to set up, because the guys need a bit of distance from the ones who are engaged to be able to shoot them effectively. So our tactics are going to have to evolve as time goes by. Let's jump down here. Unfortunate. 10 damage there from falling on our face. For someone who's used to being on ships and climbing the masts and things, it's probably fairly embarrassing for her to have fallen there. So, oh, I shouldn't have reloaded. What I should have done was gone to that gap in the building over there and laid a black powder trap there, but obviously it didn't. So let's overwatch stance instead.
A new round has started.
Okay, so game night gets to start here by hitting her, which is great. Then you can take a dodge stance. Paris now can switch weapons back to his gun, reload for one. Now who can he shoot? He can shoot her. Okay, so he's only gonna get one shot, so that needs to be an aim shot. And let's hope he hits. Okay, and then let's reload for two and be ready for the next round. end his turn. But if we're struggling this much against the hench ladies, just imagine what's going to happen when their heroes and their leader get here. So I'm guessing that lady had some wardstone on her, the one that we put out of action earlier, and that's why she yielded her. So hopefully when we deal with her, we can take it off her. Brascus now is engaged, so he can switch weapons. See, ideally, I was hoping that they would be stood in the gap behind her in the kind of, I suppose, the doorway, so that there was only one of them there, and so this whole battle would be maybe about a meter forward. There would have been only one of them, and we would have had two or three people, but didn't work out like that. So let's swing in with Brascus. Dodge fail is great. Great for us anyway, not too great for her. And then let's take our own dodge. Hope that doesn't fail. Okay, so Morjax and reload for one. And now all of our shots are going to be shooting into combat. But luckily we have our blue pills now to aim. So we're going to aim at her. Try and get her right between the eyes, please, Morjax. Okay, that's nice. Speaking of Morjax, I was actually watching his Astroneer. His Astroneer series last night. Trying to catch up on the different series I was watching. He's restarted his base, but he's got a really, I think anyway, a really nice spot where he started. And, it's definitely, if you're into kind of resource collecting and exploring type games, building type games, it's definitely something you should go and check out. Let's get David here reloaded. And also last night I was actually watching some of David's videos as well. At the moment he's doing Skaven, and I was watching him play one of the story missions, which is in like, it's a keep. You've probably seen it if you've watched any story missions before. It's I think it's the human mercenary's home base in one of the undead missions where you go and attack. But in that one, he was facing off against Chaos and a huge ogre as well. It's a pretty exciting battle to watch. Let's get David's shot aimed here. Okay, so she is almost dead. But almost dead means that she can still do damage to us. Let's end the turn. Now here's the Murder Superior coming. She seems to be carrying a torch as well, because the background lit up there as she was passing by. Oh, I think she's on fire or something. Something crazy going on there with her anyway. She's gonna come around behind us, so Grace is probably the one that will get involved with her. Okay, so let's try and be clever here with Grace. So the Mother Superior is there, so she's gonna come over this ramp. So if I put down a trap here, it's not going to hit our guys, I hope. So let's put a trap there, right in her way. Then let's move out of the way. I think we're safe, but I want to nudge a bit further forward, just in case. Let's reload. Let's just end her turn there. Okay, that's good.
A new round has started.
Okay, so let's get going now with Brascus. See if we can hit this lady. We've got two of them here, almost out of action. If we get rid of them, we've got the Mother Superior hopefully running into a trap. Then we can't pile guys onto her, because again the rules are that only if our guys are engaged can they switch weapons. So I'm not sure if that means that if they've already switched weapons whether they can continue in melee, but I'm going to try and shoot her as much as possible. We've also got the hero knocking about as well, so we definitely don't want to be fighting both of those at the same time. But let's see if we can at least put the numbers a bit more in our favor by taking out some of these hench ladies. So that's a good start, a nice hit there. And then let's dodge. Now, Game Knight has been doing really well against this lady, so hopefully the trend continues. Oh, and that's a really nice arrow you got in your face there, madam. It's actually so nice that I think I want to get a photo of it. Thank you for posing there, and let's hit her. Okay, there she goes, thank you. Now, I don't think she actually has anything on her, but we'll check anyway. So she's got a shield and a flail. I'm not going to take them because this other lady here beside us, we know has Wordstone that she took from the first one we put out of action. So Game Knight now, what do I want to do with him? I think I want to put him here, engage with her, just because we've got another one on her way, and we want to kind of block up this area so that she can't get to Paris. So let's do that and take the dodge. Paris now, he doesn't hardly have a shot at her, so he can just overwatch with his pistols for now. Okay, she passed her all alone, and she hit Brascus. Okay, Morjax has an 11% chance hitting her. Let's see if we move about a bit whether we can, yeah, we can make that better, but is that, yeah, it's her as well. Let's aim the shot to make it even better. Hopefully this is the end of her. Okay, that's good. Now let's move him up and see what kind of wordstone she had. Oh, she actually just took her tome, which is a bit strange. Let's take the shield, seeing as we need shields. And then move him back this way. Reload. And then he's possibly going to be the... I probably should have actually put him a bit further over so that Paris wasn't a much superior target. Let's end his turn. So David can reload. Then he can come here, plug this gap. Oh no, actually. Then he can get hit by the black powder trap. So let's put him over here and overwatch. pick, so here comes the Mother Superior. Oh, she actually came back around. Okay, but she did get an arrow to the face, which is good. Please blow yourself up. No such luck. Now she's going to be very difficult to deal with. And then we've got, obviously, an additional hero coming as well. Okay, so Grace now. So let's just check where the hero is. So the hero is apparently still all the way down there. So we're not too worried about her at the moment. So let's just focus on the Mother Superior. Let's aim a shot at her. Lucky to miss, and then let's reload. We're not going to proceed, we're just going to end our turn. Okay, so here's another one coming. She hits really hard compared to us with our little dinky daggers.
A new round has started.
Okay, so game night, please hit her. Okay, that's nice, but 11 damage. It's going to take us a while to put her out of action. Come on, Brascus, you know you can do it. So I think I'm going to rearrange the guys behind now. To give Brascus the chance to disengage next round. So Paris is going to reload for one. Okay, then we're going to see. So we're two word zone away. Now obviously Paris can't get any more because he's got four. But let's see if there are any easy ones to snag. Doesn't look like it. And there's their car as well. So if things start going south, someone's going to have to head to their cart, I think, and nab their idol to force them to start having to check for route. So let's aim at their leader. Okay, that's a nice hit to the face there. And reload for two. And then in their turn. Okay, now Morjax here is looking nice and healthy, so he's going to move back. Okay, that should be enough. Aim is shot. Can we not be the leader? So we really want to focus fire if we can. Yeah, he's gonna have to move. Ah no, so it is the leader this time. So, but let's make sure we aim the shot. Okay, it looks like we're not going to be able to crit her anytime soon. So let's end our turn. Okay, David now can move back out of the way. Let's get into this little bit here. Yeah, reload. Let's get him shot on the leader as well. 80%. Good. Get some pills to play with. Let's try over here. Okay, there we go. 45. Let's aim that shot. Okay, that's good. So it was just her, and we didn't have to worry about the hench lady. I'd be feeling good now about taking her out, but I'd pretty good about that dodge as well. Not that hit though. So Game Knight has maybe one or two more rounds left in him. And now here's the hero. Just to add to our troubles. Okay, so she's not interested in a fight at the moment, which is good. And now Brace can aim for a shot. Okay, that's great. So she's one lucky dagger hit from Game Knight from going out of action. So now the question is, do we go and try to get some more Wardstone? Because looking at the amount that's been claimed, the only people who have Wardstone on them are our people. So, but doing that would mean having to go towards the hero that we're trying to avoid. So I think for now, just going for a win is the best we can do. So let's end our turn. Brascus is really not enjoying being up in the front line there.
A new round has started.
Okay, so if you can disengage, which you can, let's do that. Move him this way. So I think Brascus is just gonna head to their cart. Okay, and then in his turn here. Game Knight, I could disengage him, but I really want to take this swing and see what happens. So let's do that. And there we go. So kill on the leader is breaking him. Let's move him up a bit. Eat her. So we'll take her Warhammer so we can sell it. And now they're going to start testing for route now. So he's going to, how many? He's got one more slot, so he's going to go look for some Wordstone in this direction. Oh, that was stupid. But I will switch him to his bow next round so that he has, so that he can help out here if we need him to. Is going to shoot this lady. Oh, nice hit there. Reload for one. And then he's going to take a dodge sense. Okay, Morjax is going to aim his shot. Reload one, and then he can dodge as well. David can reload. Let's aim the shot. Oh, that's a nice crit there. Crit stun, so that's the first one of this match. Then end of turn. And there we go, route test failure. So it wasn't perfect tactics from us, but the tactics certainly did help in making sure that we didn't have a basically a melee fight with the best melee warband in the game. And also, we might have got a bit lucky on some of our rolls, but overall I think we did pretty well this one. So the most valuable warrior was Game Knight, collecting lots of wordstone as usual. From the map, we got one fragment and two shards, which isn't great. We got a couple of loots as well, but we got no clusters from this. So, but overall, I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. It could have, gotten caught out in the open completely.
It is even better when you're getting paid for it.
And I actually used the trap properly for once as well, which is good. So Paris got one metal advancement. Grace is almost rank 2.
The gods are with you.
Morjax has hit rank 2. He got one marshal and he's got two skill points as well. So quick reload on the way there. Game Knight is just one XP away from getting quick reload as well. So he got one physical advancement. And Brascus got
new
one
warriors
well.
Are available for hire. Your warband is getting
so
stronger.
Game. We've hit rank 2 and we now have a new warrior slot, so we're gonna have to see who we pick for that. And then we've got 14 gold crowns, we've got a shield we're going to use, and some other stuff we're going to sell. Okay, so let's get our warband paid. It's nice not to be having to pay for any injuries. Okay, and let's spend our points before I forget. So Paris, what do I want to do with him? I want to increase his alertness so he can act earlier. Grace with no points to spend. Okay, Morjax. We're gonna obviously go for ballistic. Game Knight has one physical, so let's put that into agility for now. Make him slightly dodgier. And then Brascus, let's make him dodgier as well. Okay, and back to our warband. Let's move on the day.
New hired swords are available.
So let's go to the shop. Let's sell what we don't want. So the Sigmarite Warhammer can go. The Halberd can go. Shield, we're gonna keep the swords. I suppose, well, the sword is gonna be better guys, I guess, than the daggers until we can get enough maces for everyone. And as Game Knight said, everybody will be amazing. Okay, so seeing as it was Game Knight's idea here, so this is Game Knight here, let's give him skills. Let's give him goat entry. Let's give him the shield in his offhand. When we get a mace, we'll switch this sword to a mace. Okay, and then let's have a look at the missions for next time. So we have a brutal, good, and exceptional. It's a mark for death. A normal, average, and very poor. And a hard, poor, and average. So poor. Wordstone for a hard mission. Never going to do that, sorry. Okay, so this looks like the one we're probably going to do. One warband is caught exploring buildings while the other deploys tightly around his wagon. So either way, we should be pretty close to each other, so we can get into one group and then we can hopefully use similar tactics, maybe slightly better tactics than we did this time, and catch the enemy in smaller groups. Next time as well, we're going to look at what hero we can get the person named and customized and all that kind of stuff. So I'll do a lot of that off camera and introduce you to them once I've got them ready. But that does bring us to the end of this episode. So if you have enjoyed the episode, please consider subscribing, liking, and posting a comment below. I've been really blown away by the response from the first couple of videos in the series, with so many comments and so many tips, and it's been really great. I've been really enjoying reading what people have wrote and responding as well. So if you do post a comment, I'm obviously going to respond to you, and you know, if you want to, please do so. But I'm rambling now, so I'm going to end the video here, and I really do hope to see all of you next time. Goodbye.